Hello, everyone. My name is Kevin Harris, and I'm one of the chief residents in internal medicine at the Cleveland Clinic. My co-chiefs and I wanted to take a minute out of our schedule to talk to you about the categorical track at the Cleveland Clinic and some of the opportunities that that track has to offer. The categorical track is the largest track at Cleveland Clinic, and it makes up the majority of residents that graduate from our training program. In fact, the majority of chief residents graduated as categorical track residents. Our categorical track is organized into an X plus Y system with a 4+1 structure, which means that you have one Y week or ambulatory clinic week where you serve as the primary care physician for a panel of patients, followed by four X weeks where you're primarily in the hospital. Those X weeks are composed of a lot of different experiences, some of which are inpatient, some of which are electives, some of which are research opportunities. And to talk a bit more about what those X weeks look like, I'm going to pass it over to my co-chief, Aaron.
All right, great. Thanks so much, Kevin. So I'm Aaron, another one of the chiefs. As Kevin said, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the X week structure. As he said, we are 4+1, and so those four X weeks are what we're going to talk about now. So we do have multiple different inpatient floor rotations. These include our general ward rotations on internal medicine. We have 8 general services, and additionally a 9th service, which has a nephrology twist to it. In addition, we have subspecialty services, including cardiology, oncology, and hepatology, where you actually function as the primary service taking care of the patients rather than a consultant. In addition, we have rotations in our medical ICU and cardiac ICU, which all of our residents rotate through and get some great education there. We have multiple consultant services as well, ranging from your general cardiology, pulmonology, hematology, things of those natures, and also more subspecialized. We also have additional electives that you can rotate on. This includes our AMET rotation, which is rotating with our emergency response team, seeing patients in crisis and helping to manage them directly on the floor. We also have a pleural service rotation where you can work on thoracentesis and several other electives. Also during this elective time, you can take research, which can include up to 8 weeks of dedicated research block time outside of some of the other tracks. We also have clinics that you can rotate on as an elective, which include, you know, any of our subspecialty clinics, running the gamut of all different kinds of options. And this is outside of your Y week, so just additional clinics you can rotate on. To talk about more about the Y week clinics, I'm going to go ahead and pivot over to Andy, one of our ambulatory chiefs.
Hey, everybody. Well, I may be biased, but Y week is my favorite part of residency. So in your Y week, we have 9 different sites to choose from for your longitudinal clinic. The main one is here at main campus. We have about 50% of residents here. The rest are spread out throughout the community. So one is Stephanie Tubbs Jones Clinic in East Cleveland. This is an underserved population you'll be caring for. And the rest are in our community, more in the suburbs, a little more bread and butter medicine. While you're in your Y week, you'll be caring for a panel of patients that you'll follow throughout your 3 years here. You build really great relationships and really get close with your patients. You also have mentors and your physicians that you're working with, as you'll have the same preceptors throughout your 3 years. During your Y week, you'll have 6 half days of clinic. You'll have 1 subspecialty half day. That's where you work with a specialist in their clinic. You have the same specialist throughout most of your residency, and a lot of these preceptors will end up being letter writers, sponsoring research projects for our residents, and we find it really valuable. The other 2 half days will be spent in didactics. So I'm going to pass it over to Brandon Bungo, one of our curriculum chiefs.
Thanks, Andy. Hey there, I'm Brandon. I'm one of the chiefs in charge of the curriculum. I want to take a little bit of time to talk to you about the educational opportunities we have here. Similar to our schedule for our rotations, our curriculum is divided between our X and Y weeks. During the X week lectures, we have several different noon conferences with some unique educational opportunities. Some of our seniors will present case conferences on some of the fantastic patients they see here at Cleveland Clinic. And we have our world leaders here present during our esteemed educator series on topics in their fields. We also have our clinical reasoning conference in which we review metacognition or thinking about thinking and learning a little bit more about what drives our decision-making process. We also have the very popular high-value care conference in which we learn how to give not only evidence-based medicine to our patients, but high-value care as well. All of our residents are able to attend the X week lectures regardless of where they're at in their schedule. But during your Y week, you'll have some additional unique educational opportunities. This includes during your intern year, a specific ambulatory lecture series dedicated to some topics that you'll see very frequently on the primary care side of things. Additionally, we have a physical exam series to hone your physical exam skills, as well as some EKG reading sessions to learn some of the other skills you'll need to be a successful physician. During your senior year, you'll join our modified PBL session, which is very popular among our senior residents. This involves going over several different cases with some associated questions, as well as developing your own learning objectives and own clinical questions that you'll investigate in real time. All of this is then discussed with an expert in the field to learn how they approach these difficult cases. I'm going to pass it off to Steph next to give you a little bit of a summary of everything we've discussed.
Hi everyone, I'm Steph. I'm the other ambulatory chief. I wanted to say hi and thank you for joining us on behalf of me and one of our other chiefs, Caitlin, who's currently on maternity leave right now. Some of you may get to meet her during interviews. So I just wanted to clarify and summarize that we have so many opportunities here at Cleveland Clinic. We're a massive program and we host a robust categorical track as well as many of the other kind of specialized tracks that you see in other videos. Our categorical track is really the basis for every single clinical experience and educational experience that anybody, regardless of track, is going to participate in. And we graduate many very successful residents from here. It's a very satisfying experience. So please feel free to apply to our track as well as any of the other tracks that you may see fit. Thank you for your time, and we hope to see you soon.